to the Advent Storytime series. Today is what day?
The
24th. What does that mean? If it's the 24th, what is it? Christmas Eve! That's so exciting! And if it's Christmas Eve, how many more days till Christmas?
Four.
One more day till Christmas. It's so exciting. All right, let's count to 24. Are you ready? We count together. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. All right, can you find the 24 in our advent calendar?
It's a person.
Let's see who it is. Who is it? Oh, it's the drummer boy. How cute is that? Show him the drummer boy. What sound does a drum make? Right, tap, tap. Boom, boom, boom. All right, where can he go? Is there a spot for him? Good. Oh, perfect. Okay. Are you ready for today's story? It's called Itsy Bitsy Christmas, because you're never too little for his love. Okay. Bitsy, watch out. Itsy grabbed his little sister's tail and pulled her back just in time. The big wagon rolled past and splashed them with mud. Be careful, Bitsy. You don't want to get run over. Bitsy jumped back and gulped. Her big eyes grew even wider. I've never seen Bethlehem so busy, she exclaimed. People are everywhere. Wagons rolling, cows mooing, donkeys pulling, and camels. Do you know that camels spit? Bitsy stepped away from the camel nearest her. What is going on, Itsy? Follow me and I'll show you, the older mouse replied. Itsy took his sister's hand and they scampered to the top of the city wall. It's time to count all the people. Everyone has to go to their hometown and sign the big book. Bitsy looked around. This is a big day for Bethlehem. Big day indeed, said a deep voice behind him. Itsy and Bitsy turned. A donkey was talking to them. The mice were on the wall so they could see him face to face. Whoa, you're big, said Itsy. I've never seen inside the nose of a donkey, he added, peering inside the nostril. Ew, Bitsy offered. Who are you? She asked the donkey. I'm Daniel from a faraway town. Are you here to be counted? No, he said very slowly. I'm here because of the king. What? Haven't you heard? The king is coming to Bethlehem. But Bethlehem is an itsy bitsy town, Bitsy exclaimed. Why would a king come here? This king is special. He comes for everyone, big and small. Like us? Itsy asked. Like you. Bitsy turned, her whiskers bouncing. Itsy, we need to tell our friends. Yes, yes, Itsy agreed. They will want to see the king too. The mice dashed between the feet, hooves, and a rolling wagon wheels and ran towards their stable. They scurried under the gate, up the stable posts, and on to their favorite rafter. From their spot high above the floor, they could see all their friends. Ruthie, the mama horse, was the biggest. Rowdy, the rooster, was perched on the rail. Six sheep were crowded in the corner. Charlie, the cow, grazed on some hay. Grumpy, the goat, sulked in another corner. He never smiled. He was always mad at someone. Itsy cupped his hands over his mouth and squeaked. Okay, everyone, gathered in. We need to talk. No one moved. Bitsy tried. We have big news. No response. Bitsy turned to Rowdy the rooster. Can you help us? Sure, replied Rowdy. I love any excuse to make some noise. He leaned his head back. Cock-a-doodle-doo! The animals lifted their heads. Hey, groaned Grumpy the goat. Knock it off. I'm trying to nap. Itsy and I have big news. You're moving? Grumpy muttered. Grumpy, be nice, said Ruthie, the mama horse. Itsy and Bitsy, tell us your big news. The king is coming to Bethlehem. To us. No one spoke for a long time. Then Rowdy crowed. A king to Bethlehem? That will never happen. The others snorted, baaed, neighed, and mooed in agreement. Kings come to important places, offered the sheep. And to important people, agreed Grumpy. Not to places like Bethlehem or to mice like you. Itsy and Bitsy, Ruthie the mama horse spoke up. I'm afraid this place is too common for a king. No king would care about us. Itsy looked at Bitsy. Well, Bitsy and I are going to find the king. Good luck with that, chuckled Grumpy. To see the king, to see the king. Bitsy zipped down the post and out to the street. But when she stopped, Itsy, where will we find him? Itsy paused for a moment, placing his finger on his chin. Well, let's go to where important people go, the city gate. Off they went. The leaders of the town sat at the city gate, making decisions. Bitsy spotted a wise owl sitting on top of the gate. Mr. Owl, she shouted, we hear that a king is coming to Bethlehem. Have you seen him? A king in tiny little Bethlehem? You won't find a king here. So the king hadn't come to the wise ones at the city gate. I know, Itsy offered. Let's go to the camels. Let's go to where the camels live. Kings ride on camels, right? So the two mice scampered over to the camel corral. Mr. Camel, shouted Itsy, we are looking for a king. Have you seen him? Silly mouse, I've carried some very rich and important men in my day, but I assure you, they didn't come here. Kings don't come to common places like Bethlehem. But we talked to a donkey and... Never trusted donkey, snickered the camel. Itsy sighed, where else can we look? Well, let's look everywhere, said Bitsy. The mice ran to the main street where the busy people rushed around. Lots of busy people, but no king. They ran to the hotel where the sleepy people spent time resting. Lots of sleepy people, but no king. They ran to the city market where the business people worked all day. Lots of working people, but no king. Finally, Itsy and Bitsy began to get tired. It was getting dark. Let's go home, Bitsy. Itsy sighed. Everyone is right. No king is coming for us. We aren't important enough. Bitsy started to object, but didn't. A tear formed on her cheek as they headed towards home. I always wanted to see a king. Now I guess I never will. But when the mice neared the stable, they saw Daniel the donkey, the same one who had told them about the king. Itsy and Bitsy ran up to the stable fence. We have looked all over town for the king. We couldn't find him. Well, said the donkey in his low, slow voice, you just did. Daniel motioned with his head to the center of the stable where all the animals stood in a circle. The two mice scampered up a fence post and looked. A little baby was asleep in the manger. Who is he? Asked Itsy. He is the king, replied Ruthie. Just like you said, a king came to Bethlehem. His name is Jesus, explained Daniel the donkey. God sent him to love us, help us, and save us. He came for me, even though I laughed at you? Asked Rudy the rooster. And for us, even though we doubted you? Asked the sheep. And me? I can get cranky, admitted Grumpy. Daniel smiled and nodded his big head. God sent Jesus for us all. Who would have thought, observed Itsy, a king for everyone. A tiny tear of joy rolled all the way down Bitsy's nose. He came, Bitsy said with a smile, even for a little one like me. Oh, I liked that story, did you?
They look at the back.
Oh, they're giving hugs. That story made me feel very happy in my heart. Did you like that one? Oh, I sure did. Because Jesus came for everyone, no matter how little or how big you are. Yes, he did. Okay, I hope that you liked it, and I know that you're getting excited. So how about you join us tomorrow for our very last Advent story time? Will you do that? Okay, bye-bye.